This is a triangle made of dots. While it may not seem too remarkable, the patterns within it and all other triangles like it hold secrets of addition. Today, I'm going to show you those patterns, how they relate to this formula, and why they create something called the factorial for addition. But hold on, what exactly is a factorial? To sum it up in two words, you could say it's the idea of descending multiplication. But if you want something even more concise, mathematicians condense that idea into this expression. To illustrate what it does, let's look at an example. Take the number 5. The factorial of the number 5 is the multiplication of all the numbers up to and including 5. Another way you could look at this process is taking 5, then multiplying it by 5 minus 1, then 5 minus 2, and so on until the number in the parentheses is 1. And with this perspective, you can probably see why it encapsulates the idea of descending multiplication. But other than representing that idea, factorials contain a useful pattern within themselves that some of you may have spotted. By taking a factorial of a number, you're essentially multiplying it by the factorial of that number minus 1. This type of pattern where a process contains a smaller version of itself is called recursion, and it'll help us connect the idea of factorials to our triangles at the start of the video. Also, if you're unfamiliar with recursion, definitely check out my video explaining it in detail after this one. If we try to construct an equilateral triangle out of dots, it'll look something like this, where each row gains one more dot as we go down the triangle. When curious mathematicians saw this method of creating a triangle, they set out to answer one question. If we have a triangle that is x rows high, how many dots do we need to create it? In pursuit of that answer, they came up with a concept called triangular numbers, denoted by T of n. What this T of n tells us is that for a triangle of n rows, the number of dots needed to create that triangle is equal to this formula. But you may be asking, how do mathematicians know this is the formula that tells us the number of dots we need? To answer that, we can do what they did and create it from scratch by leveraging the patterns within our triangles. Like before, let's use the number 5 in our example. If we have a triangle that's 5 rows high, we can see a few things right off the bat. For starters, since this triangle has 5 rows, we can see that the bottom row is made up of 5 dots. We also know that for each row we go up by, the number of dots in a row decreases by 1. Let's write the number of dots in each row off to the side. Now, the next couple of patterns are a bit tricky to spot, but they're at the heart of why our formula works. If we take the first and last row of the triangle and add them, we get 6. We also get 6 if we add the second and second to last rows. The third row doesn't have a pair, so we leave it as 3. Because our triangle is 5 rows high, we know that n equals 5, so we can rewrite 6 as n plus 1. Additionally, if we combine all the sums we found earlier, we get the total number of dots in the triangle. Next, by dividing this number by 6, we get 2.5, which tells us how many times we can fit 6 dots into our triangle. It's also exactly half of the number of rows in our triangle, so we can call it n over 2. If we multiply 6 and 2.5 together, it gives us the total number of dots in our triangle. This means that n plus 1 times n over 2 equals the total number of dots because of the equalities we just discovered. And if we rewrite this expression just a tiny bit, we get the formula that we saw a few minutes ago. And the whole process we just went through was how mathematicians derived it. But there's another set of patterns within these triangles I want to talk about to connect them back to factorials. As I mentioned before, we know that a triangle with 5 rows will have 5 dots on the bottom row. But if we take away that bottom row, we get a triangle with 4 rows where the bottom row has 4 dots. This process can be repeated until we get to the top of the triangle. If this looks familiar, that's because, like factorials, triangular numbers have a recursive relationship inside of them, where the nth triangular number equals n plus the nth minus 1 triangular number. And by fully expanding this logic, we get an expression that looks identical to a factorial if we substituted the multiplication for addition. Which I think is cool, because by asking a simple question on how we could expand the idea of factorials to addition, it took us on a fairly unexpected journey through triangular numbers and taught us how we can leverage patterns to yield mathematical insight. And if you enjoyed that journey, you could go on another one by watching some of my other videos. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed learning the math behind the factorial for addition.